Jeez. Cheers, Vaughn. I've had to wait till last. I've had to stew on that, and then I've had to follow the great Ray Warren in. But the room's full of greatness. Thank you to the NRL and the Hall of Fame. Everyone's been involved in the whole process. Congratulations to the inductees. Amazing inductees, Albs, Rubes and Stace. Many battles against the Kiwis. Just got so much respect for everyone that pulls on that jersey. And the nominees as well. I think the nominees, everyone that didn't get the nod, I'm sure they'll be standing up here in years to come. So let's have a crack at this. I don't know where it's going to end up, like my career. I don't know. I did not set out to know where that was going to end up. A Taree boy, bowie-legged Taree boy. Came to Newcastle pretty early, about 15. So I've got to thank my mum and dad for that, because being a parent myself, I understand that letting your kids go pretty early is a pretty big thing. So I used to go past Joey's house, so that's where the great Andrew Johns lives. I've got to thank you, mate. Pretty honoured to say I had a combination with you. Not off the field, but on the field, definitely. We had some great times, we had some great moments on the field and off the field, and especially now, I think this is another one of those moments, mate, I'll always cherish. So, and then so in 97, the Knights win the grand final, and all I tried to do ever since then is get out of bed and do my best to be an NRL Knights player and to win a competition. And what that did for the town and the community really showed me what rugby league's all about. It's about a game that's the people's game. It's a blue-collar game, and I'm in love with the game. So all I tried to do was win a competition. 2001, I was lucky enough to do that. So that's a big box ticked. And on I go to the UK Super League and had a fantastic 3 years over there and met so many people. What I got out of the game, okay, for me, the things that matter is relationships and friends and respect. And to stand here in front of you tonight, hopefully I've got those, so it's pretty cool. To my wife down there, so we're still involved in the game and I'm still going up and down that M1 all the time and you're still at home with the kids, so doing a sensational job. So thank you for everything. My mum and dad and my brother, I was a bit of a leg rope to my brother growing up. I was 2 years younger, and so I know I hung around him, and he's the emotional type. So Brock, thanks for all your help and support over the years. And to my kids, just amazing. I'm seeing them grow up now and play the game as an under eight and an under six, and I'm really happy for them to see where this game's going to end up for them. So they've got dreams, and I'm a part of that. So once again, thank you to everyone. Thank you to the Newcastle Knights fans. That's the other thing, sorry, the Newcastle Knights fans. Mean the world to me, and all the support and my teammates have given me over the last 48 hours has been phenomenal, and that's what it means to me. So thanks so much, guys. All the best. Thank you.